Assalamualaikum dan salam sejahtera. Hi guys, welcome to KMJ. So, for chemistry subject, we are going to start with chapter 1, which is matter. For this chapter, we have 3 subtopics, 1.1, 1.2 and 1.3. So, for now, we are going to learn subtopic 1.1, which is atoms and molecule. So guys, let's start. Okay guys, in subtopic 1.1, atoms and molecule, we are going to discover about, actually this one you already learned in school, which is subatomic particle, which is neutron, proton, electron. So you are very familiar about these three things. And then we are going to learn about isotope notation and mass spectrometer. Okay guys, so as we know that an atomic nucleus consists of proton and neutron. So what is proton? So proton number is number of proton in the nucleus of each atom. Okay, so normally the proton number also called as atomic number. So you can find the proton number in periodic table. Okay guys, and then we have nucleon number. So nucleon number is total number of proton and neutron in the nucleus of an atom. So to calculate the nucleon number, you need to add number of proton with number of neutron for atom. Okay, so nucleon number also called as mass number. Ini juga boleh you dapati daripada periodic table. Biasanya you gunakan nucleon number or mass number ni sebagai GCM atom relative. Still remember, if you want to calculate the molar mass ataupun GCM molar. Okay, next we look at isotope. So what is isotope? Isotope is two or more atoms of the same element having same proton number but different nucleon number. Okay, for example here, I have isotope of hydrogen. We have three type of isotope for hydrogen. The first one, we have protium. The second one, we have deuterium. And then the third one, we have tritium. Okay, so between these three isotope of hydrogen, what is the difference, guys? The difference is the nucleon number. Okay, but the number of proton for these three isotope sama. Same proton number, which is 1. But look at the nucleon number for protium, 1. Deuterium, 2. While tritium, 3. So, this is what we call as isotope. Okay, next, I will teach you how to write the isotopic notation. Okay, so for isotopic notation, untuk tulis isotope notation, it should be like this. Okay, we have the symbol for atomic, for atom. Okay, atomic symbol here. And then, dekat atas ni adalah A ni stand for nucleon number, while Z, this one, is stand for proton number. Okay, for example here, I have chlorine atom. Okay, so if you look at the periodic table, the proton number for chlorine is 17. And then the mass number or the nucleon number is 35. So this is how you write the isotopic notation for an atom. Okay, kalau untuk ion, case dia lain lah. Okay, dia akan ada charge. Okay guys, next we look at mass spectrometer. So this mass spectrometer is analytical instrument used to measure atomic mass or molecular mass directly. So this is the example of mass spectrometer that we use in lab. Dalam matriculation, kita tidak ada mass spectrometer. So, kalau you nak jumpa mass spectrometer, you kena masuk university lah. Kalau you ambil chemistry. Okay, so this is the component of mass spectrometer. So, if you look here, okay, this mass spectrometer will start with here, vaporization chamber, ionization chamber, and then this one is acceleration chamber, and we have the magnetic field here, and to vacuum the pump, and this is the ion detector. Alright, so apa cara ataupun cara dia berfungsi, you tak perlu tahu. Okay, you just need to know that what is the function of mass spectrometer only for your syllabus. Okay, apa yang kita boleh dapat daripada mass spectrometer? So, jom saya tunjukkan. Okay guys, so this is the important thing that you need to know. Okay, sebab ini boleh ditanya dalam soalan. Mass spectrum. So this is what we call as mass spectrum. Okay, this one for chlorine isotope. So look, look at this mass spectrum. Dia macam graph. Tapi dia macam graph bar, tapi dia bukan graph bar ya. Dia satu line. Okay, kalau you tengok dekat sini, pada paksi kat sini kita ada paksi Y dengan paksi Z, tapi dia tak ada anak panah dekat sini macam graph. Okay, dia just one line only. Okay, at the y-axis here, kita label as relative abundance. Okay, dia boleh jadi dalam bentuk percentage ataupun dalam bentuk nilai biasa. Okay, and then kita ada relative mass. Yang ini adalah mass number, normally lah. Okay, ataupun nucleon number. So, kita ada 35 and 37. So, menunjukkan chlorine consists of two isotope. So, look here. Chlorine 35 isotope higher relative abundance. It means that dia terhasil lebih banyak daripada chlorine 37. So you kena faham baca mass spectrum ni. Sebab nanti kita akan belajar kira average atomic mass. Okay guys, now we look at atomic mass unit. AMU, the unit. Okay, we need to use the unit is AMU or U. So what is atomic mass? So atomic mass is a mass exactly equal to 1/12 of the mass of carbon 12 atom. Okay, so we know that the mass of carbon 12 atom, the value is 12 AMU. Zaman sekolah dulu korang pakai GC molar kan? GC molar 12 gram per mole. Ingat lagi? So, untuk matriculation, kita tak pakai gram per mole. Kita pakai 12 AMU, which is atomic mass unit. Sebenarnya, atomic mass ni adalah GC atom. Kan? Sama macam you all belajar dulu. Okay, and then we have molecular mass. Molecular mass, what is the difference between atomic mass? Molecule. Molecule means combination more than one atom. So, molecular mass is the sum of the atomic mass in AMU in a molecule. Okay, I have example here. For example, you ada sulfur dioxide gas. Okay, so inside the sulfur dioxide gas consists of 3 atoms. We have 1 sulfur atom and 2 oxygen atom. So if you refer to the periodic table ataupun you refer kepada table relative atomic mass, okay, I will introduce to you later about the table relative atomic mass. So sulfur atom, 1 sulfur atom, the molecular mass, not molecular mass, atomic mass adalah 32.07 AMU. So what, where you can find the value here adalah melalui periodic table lah, normally yang you dah belajar masa sekolah. And then for the oxygen atom, the atomic mass ataupun GCM atom dia adalah 16 gram AMU. So you need to times 2 because we have 2 oxygen atom. So the total atomic mass here equal to 64.07 amu. So this what we call as molecular mass ataupun you biasa panggil jisim molecule. Ah, sama je. So you need to know how to calculate molecular mass. Alright guys, next we look at average atomic mass. Average, purata. Okay, so what is average atomic mass? The average of mass of each naturally isotope weight according to their abundance. Just now we know that hydrogen consists of 3 isotopes and then chlorine consists of 2 isotopes, right? So untuk nilai yang kita masukkan dalam periodic table, dia adalah berdasarkan average atomic mass, like this. Okay, so we need to use this formula to calculate average atomic mass, which is the formula is relative intensity or relative abundance. Abundance tu adalah kelimpahan dia, yang dia hasilkan. Abundance tu yang terhasil. Okay, darab dengan isotopic mass, divide by total relative intensity or abundance. Okay, so this average atomic mass yang kita masukkan ke dalam periodic table. Macam tadi kita tahu chlorine. Chlorine tadi kita tahu ada 2 isotope. So nak ambil yang mana satu nilai dia? 35 ke 37? Ingat lagi tak tadi? Okay, so cara dia adalah berdasarkan average atomic mass. So baru kita dapat masukkan nilai mass number dia dalam periodic table. Okay, so later I will teach you how to calculate average atomic mass. Okay guys, next we look at relative atomic mass, or dalam bahasa Melayunya yang biasa you belajar adalah jisim atom relative. J-A-R, remember? Sama je kelas, okay? So what is relative atomic mass? The mass of one atom of element compared to 1/12 the mass of one atom of carbon 12. Ayat ni macam susah nak faham kan? So look at this formula. Ni formula di kelas. Okay, so mass of one atom of an element in AMU divide by 1 over 12 times mass of one carbon atom. Okay, I'll show you like this. I take oxygen atom. Oxygen atom kita ada berapa dia punya atomic mass? We know that 16 AMU divide by 1 over 12 times 12. 12 ni mana? Ni carbon atom. Carbon atom adalah 12 AMU. So what we need to do, we can cancel out the 12 divide by 12, and then we also can cancel out the AMU. So what is the relative atomic mass for oxygen? So the answer should be 16.0 without unit. So sebenarnya relative atomic mass ni the value same like atomic mass. What is the difference? Only the unit. Okay, so you need to show how you convert atomic mass to relative atomic mass. You need to show by using this formula. Okay, and then we have relative molecular mass. Same like relative atomic mass. Sama kelas, sama. Cuma atomic mass refer to atom only, but molecular mass refer to the molecule, the combination of atom, like SO2 just now, remember? Okay, so this is the definition and this is the formula. Okay, the method same like relative atomic mass that I'll show you just now. Okay, but you need to calculate the molecular mass first. How? Saya dah tunjukkan macam mana kira sulfur dioxide just now. Okay guys, so this is the table relative atomic mass that you need to use in matriculation. So in exam also, this table will be provided in your question paper. Okay, so you tolonglah guna table ni sebagai panduan untuk chemistry subject. Okay, so kalau boleh lepas ni tolong print dan simpan dalam fail untuk you all buat latihan sepanjang semester 1 ini. Okay guys? So dekat sini, if you look at this table, we have a symbol for atom. So you can refer here. And we have the element, we have the proton number, and we have the relative atomic mass. Relative atomic mass ni lah adalah jisim molar. Okay, yang awak kena guna dalam mengira atomic mass atau molecular mass. Okay guys, so now we look at this example, how to calculate average atomic mass. Okay, look at this question. Okay, we read the question together. So, or you can refer to your lecture note. Also, I use the same question. Okay, look here. We have two isotopes of chlorine and we have the percentage abundant here. So, percentage abundant for the first isotope is 75.77%, for chlorine 35, and then 24.23% of chlorine 37. Okay, so this is relative abundance. And then, you also given in this question adalah atomic mass for chlorine 35 and atomic mass of chlorine 37. So, the first question asks you to calculate average atomic mass for chlorine atom. So, how to calculate average atomic mass? You need to use this formula, which is relative abundance times isotopic mass and divide by total relative intensity or abundance. Okay, before we calculate the average atomic mass, look at the mass spectrum yang kat sebelah ni. Still remember tadi saya ada explain. So sometime question juga akan beri awak this mass spectrum untuk you cari average atomic mass. So you kena familiar, either dia bagi dalam bentuk sentences like this, or dia juga boleh diberi dalam bentuk mass spectrum like this. Okay, so you kena faham. Ini adalah untuk chlorine 35. Ini adalah untuk chlorine 37. Okay, so kita nak kira average atomic mass. So nak kira average atomic mass, for the first question, saya dah kata use this formula. Okay, so we have two isotope only. So cara awak buat adalah, so ini sebenarnya awak kena kira dia punya total, sum of dia. Okay, so awak akan kira 75.77 untuk chlorine 35 dulu. Okay, darab dengan dia punya atomic mass. Okay, so this one for chlorine 35 and then plus with chlorine 37. So the percentage times with atomic mass. So divide by total relative intensity. So in this case, we have the percentage. So we know that total percentage adalah equal to 100, or you can write like this. Okay, so you can write like this, or you can write 100. Okay, either one. So press your calculator, so you will get the answer is 35. So you will get the answer is 35.458 AMU. So this is your final answer for average atomic mass. Though don't forget, the unit for average atomic mass adalah AMU. Okay, now we look at the second question. So how to calculate relative atomic mass of chlorine? So bila ada words relative, dia mesti tidak ada unit. Nilai akan jadi sama kelas, tapi cuma tak ada unit. Still remember the formula? So this is the formula how you want to calculate relative atomic mass for atom. So mass of one atom of element divided by 1 over 12 times 12 amu of carbon atom. So we already calculate the average atomic mass. So we use this formula. So you can dapat like this. So we can cancel out the 12 and amu. So the final answer is 35.45 without unit. So look, question number 1 and question number 2, the answer same. What is the difference? Only the unit. Okay class, understand? So remember, average atomic mass mesti ada amu, while relative atomic mass tidak perlu ada amu. So kena guna formula tersebut. Okay guys, how to check whether your answer is correct or not? Kadang-kadang pelajar tanya macam mana nak tahu jawapan yang awak dah kira tu betul ke salah? Kan? So actually you can refer to table relative atomic mass that you have. Okay? So awak boleh check sama ada nilai average atomic mass yang awak kira tu betul ke tak? So tengok. Sebab tadi saya bagi tahu average atomic mass tu adalah nilai yang kita masukkan dalam periodic table. So find your chlorine atom punya relative atomic mass kat sini. See? So the average atomic mass here is 35.5. Just now we calculate the value of chlorine, average atomic mass of chlorine is 35.45. So betul lah kan? So this is how you check your answer. Okay? Boleh? Okay guys, now we look at the other example question for calculate average atomic mass. Okay? So look here. So now we have the nitrogen atom. So we have two isotopes of nitrogen atom, which is nitrogen 14 and nitrogen 15. So this question asks you to calculate percentage abundant. See, just now the other example, just now yang kita dah lihat, the question already given to you the percentage abundance and the isotopic mass. Nampak? So kita ada isotopic mass for nitrogen 14 and nitrogen 15. But yang diberi kat sini adalah average atomic mass for nitrogen. Kalau example sebelum ni, we need to calculate average atomic mass. But now in this question, average atomic mass already given in the question. So macam mana nak kira percentage abundance? Okay, so we still use the same formula. Okay, formula yang sama kita kaitkan dengan average atomic mass. So apa yang kita kena buat? Kita kena keluarkan maklumat dulu. Okay, so kita nak cari percentage abundant for both isotope. So we don't know. So what we need to do, kita kena gantikan dia dulu. Kita tentukan dia dulu. So kita anggapkan, so kita anggapkan macam ni, unknown X sebagai nitrogen 14 punya percentage abundant, while Y as nitrogen 15 percentage abundant. So kita keluarkan dia sebagai unknown, and then kita masukkan dalam formula by using the formula. Okay? Okay, ini adalah nilai yang saya dah masukkan dalam formula average atomic mass. So macam mana saya tahu total relative intensity adalah 100? Yang ni. Sebab we know that just now percentage total mesti 100. Nampak tak? Okay, kemudian ini kita anggap sebagai equation yang pertama. So you kena cari pula equation yang kedua. How? So we know that X plus Y should equal to 100 because this one is percentage. So X plus Y equal to 100. Kalau you ada 3 isotop pun, you boleh letak sebagai Z. So X plus Y plus Z must equal to 100. Okay? So how to solve this equation? You need to solve it by using Simultaneous equation. Tahu tak simultaneous equation tu apa? Dah belajar kan zaman sekolah. So jadikan dia sebagai satu equation untuk you combinekan dan you kena cari nilai X dan Y. So simultaneous equation tu saya tak nak ajar dekat sini lah sebab sepatutnya you all dah belajar. So saya terus bagi nilai X dan Y. So X yang saya dapat adalah 99.64 while Y adalah 0.36. So ini adalah nilai X dan Y. So please don't leave your answer like this. Okay, sebenarnya kalkulator awak tu dah boleh tekan je untuk cari simultaneous equation. Betul? Awak guna je. So final answer mesti tulis penuh. Okay, like this. Okay, so this is your final answer. Boleh kelas? So you need to practice how to solve the simultaneous equation. Okay guys, that's all for subtopic 1.1. Bye guys, thank you.